Okay, now that that's over with, Danny here from Metal Couch. Today, I'm going to be doing a classic album review. That album, Judas Priest Screaming for Vengeance, released in 1982. Ooh, 80s album. Judas Priest really need no introduction. Rob Halford, falsetto, awesome vocal range. Moving on, track listing. You have the Hellion, which kind of looking around hoping that that doesn't come back, which leads into Electric Eye. This is a perfect combo, great opener, and really starts the album off strong. The Hellion and Electric Eye, and pretty much this whole album in general, is a big inspiration for me as a guitar player. And it's just all out awesome. Not to mention Rob Halford's vocals in the chorus of Electric Eye sound fucking awesome. Next, we have Riding on the Wind, another great track, and one of my personal favorites on the album. Riding on the Wind. Yeah, anyway. Anyway, moving on. Then we have Bloodstone, which, it's okay. Not the worst track on the album, but nonetheless, pretty good. Take These Chains. Take These Chains is the ballad on this album. I hate ballads. I really do. Even some of the famous ones that people critically acclaim, such as Fade to Black, and even some of Megadeth's ballads, I could really give two shits for. Pain and Pleasure. Well, Rob Halford, wearing leather, holding a whip, singing Pain and Pleasure. I'll let that image sink into your head as I move along with. Yeah, just. I'll let that sink in. Screaming for Vengeance, the title track, is my favorite track on this album, hands down. So powerful, the screams from Halford on this song are just inhuman. I honestly want to know how anyone on this earth can scream like that. And don't you dare make a gay joke about Halford. I know people still make jokes about Rob Halford being gay, but does that really make a difference? It doesn't at all. Anyway, Screaming for Vengeance also displays KK Downing and Glenn Tipton's awesome guitar work and just how great that this pair of guitarists are. I mean, this is what new wave of British heavy metal is supposed to sound like. If you look up new wave of British heavy metal in an encyclopedia, it will say C, Screaming for Vengeance by Judas Priest. You've got another thing coming. Song after Screaming for Vengeance is probably the most famous off of this album, and it garnered mainstream airplay on MTV back when they played music videos. Headbangers Ball was constantly playing this, and well, VH1 Classics still play it all the time with Metal Mania. Great song, but it does get old hearing it for the thousandth time. Then we have Fever. Fever is. I like to think of Fever as a great guitar track. It's a good track for guitarists. Other than that, I can't really say there's anything exceptional about that. Devil's Child to close out the album. Devil's Child is another great display of Halford's vocals and just the whole band working harmoniously to kick some ass. Now, there are two bonus tracks that come with these remastered series of Judas Priest albums. The bonus tracks are Prisoner of Your Eyes, and a live rendition of Devil's Child, which was recorded live during the US World Vengeance Tour in 1982. Prisoner of Your Eye, it says on the back here, let me read this off to you. The studio bonus track Prisoner of Your Eyes was written during the earlier years of our career and recorded at Compass Point Studios, Nassau, in August of 1985. Prisoner of Your Eyes was written during the Turbo Sessions. Why is the bonus track on Screaming for Vengeance not a bonus track that was recorded during the era of Screaming for Vengeance? Why is there a Turbo song on this awesome album? I don't like Prisoner of Your Eyes. I think it's sappy. I think it's cheesy. And I don't even think it sounds like Judas Priest, to be honest. Anyway, I just want to comment on this because the artwork on this album cover right here, every time I see this album cover, I think this is how an album should look. It has a unique style, but at the same time, it's simple, and it conveys its message clearly. Screaming for Vengeance, as a whole, I fucking love this album. It was the Judas Priest album that I first listened to, and it got me into the band. I listen to a lot of these tracks daily. It is a classic album in my eyes, one of the albums that influenced me as a musician, and it really set the standard for how metal music is played, created, and all in all, even though it does have some faults, this is still an album that people remember. And it still gets airplay today. Granted, not so much because of the bullshit like Butt Plug for My Valentine and Bullet for My, in some other band that involves bullets and hearts and shit like that. You know what I mean. This is heavy metal. This is fucking awesome. This is how heavy metal should be made. I'm giving Judas Priest Screaming for Vengeance a 10 out of 10. It is a classic album. It is an influential album. Yes, there are some tracks that are very, very out of place here. I'm talking about You Take These Chains. Nonetheless, there is not a bad track on this album. It is a big influence for me. 10 out of 10 for Judas Priest Screaming for Vengeance. This is Danny here from Metal Couch, signing off.